Once a week, we attend the case conference for our endocrine group. And typically, they bring in problematic cases, and they're looking for input from their colleagues. And so this particular case, they had an individual who presented with type 1 diabetes in DKA, diabetic ketoacidosis. And so he had presented with very high serum or plasma ketone concentrations. And as part of the workup of this patient, they measured creatinine, which is what we typically measure to assess kidney function. And so creatinine is produced as kind of a byproduct of muscle cells. And typically it's removed very efficiently by the kidneys. And so if somebody has an elevated creatinine concentration in the blood, that indicates that the kidneys really aren't doing their job and there's some degree of kidney damage. So in this case, this individual had a very high serum creatinine, which led the clinicians to believe, well, maybe in addition to the DKA or potentially as part of the DKA, he also has some diminished renal function. So they treated the patient, and very rapidly, more rapidly than would be expected in a patient with true kidney injury, the creatinine dropped and dropped and dropped and fell within the normal reference interval. And so the clinicians then asked, you know, has anybody seen this before? Is there a reason for why this patient's kidneys would improve so quickly? And so I chimed in and I said, well, you know, probably what we're measuring here, this isn't truly creatinine, this is probably ketones, because we know there's nonspecific interference between ketones and our creatinine measurement method. And this patient really never had kidney injury in the first place. His kidneys were totally fine. So explaining to them how our tests work really helped them kind of move on to the more important, more meaningful pieces of this case rather than spending time on something that was more misleading. So I'm Rob Nerenz. I'm the Assistant Director of Clinical Chemistry at Dartmouth Hitchcock Medical Center.